Greetings to all of you, wherever you are in the world, at whatever time of day, and an enormous welcome to the City of London and to the Olympic Stadium for the Olympic Games of 2012. You see the stadium and the sky above you, which has been worrying us just a little bit in the last quarter of an hour, because we have had just a slight shower of rain. Many of you will know we've been having a quite extraordinary summer this year. Fair to say that we've had 3 or 4 days of quite warm sunshine, but we've had buckets and buckets of rain. And that is the last thing we want for this ceremony, which I'm sure will entertain you, which is the brainchild of Danny Boyle. Slumdog Millionaire, many of you will have seen, and his record in the cinema and for invention in so many areas. It's a quality performance that's going to be very different, I suspect, from any that you've seen before. It will be full of passion and full of heart. And I'm joined in the commentary box by Gillian Clark, famous in the world of badminton, on which sport she now commentates. How do you feel in this atmosphere?
It's absolutely electric. It really is. I've never been at an opening ceremony when I competed as a badminton player. Of course, the athletes don't come in until one of the last things on the opening ceremony, so you're kept in a holding staging area outside, and to actually be in this magnificent arena, it really is very, very special indeed.
And on my right is a man who will spend many days in this magnificent arena commentating on the athletics. And he knows what it's like to be an Olympian, because he was a high hurdler of distinction. Stu Story.
Well, thank you very much, Barry. It is a great moment. Every 4 years, there's something very special about preparing for an Olympic Games. It's so different to a World Championships, a European Championships, and all the other championships, because the world comes together, the youth of the world comes together in rivalry that is of a professional nature these days. In my day, of course, we were amateurs in Mexico City at high altitude in 1968, and how things have changed. And of course, the athletes will now be gearing up, some for the very first time, some for up to 7 and 8 Olympic Games, as we will be announcing later on as the teams come in. There will be some very special people who are very much used to this, but for me, there are those for the very first time. Those will want to be the ones in the parade. They'll want to savour this magnificent atmosphere and to be greeted by the 80,000 or so that are gathered here in this wonderful stadium. And as an athlete and as a commentator, it's been an absolute privilege over the last 30 or 40 years to be involved, and it is so today as well.
And I don't think anyone more excited or perhaps more nervous than Danny Boyle. I remember his other films, Train Spotting. One did Frankenstein at the National Theatre. Says his first Olympic memory is Bob Beamon jumping out of the pit in Mexico, 1968.
And actually, Barry, I can join you on that, because I actually stood next to the pit and watched that jump, and it was a magnificent occasion. It was the fourth jump of the first round, and it was quite something else. No one had ever jumped 28 feet before, and all of a sudden 8 meters and 90. It was that time when metric and imperial were totally not understood by all of the world, and most people didn't realize how important that jump was.
Wonderful reception from the crowd, who have clearly come to enjoy the evening, as well they should. And you join some very good company. Over 80 leaders of countries in the world, nearly 40 queens, kings or princes, general public who've paid for what they feel will be a very special occasion. And as you hear from the public address announcer, we are 1 minute away from the official start of the Games of London 2012, and they will be started by the ringing of the Olympic bell. The largest harmonically tuned bell in the world is made at the Whitechapel Bell Foundry, whose workshop is just a few miles down the road from the stadium. The foundry also created the Liberty Bell in 1752 and Big Ben in 1858. And the Olympic bell will remain here in the Olympic Park for the next 200 years. And it will be struck by the man of the hour, the man who rode with the greatest pride down the Champs-Élysées. Need I tell you more? Think about it, he must have been in all the papers all over the world, because no Briton has ever done it before. Journey down London's iconic river, the River Thames, from its source in the parish of Kemble in Gloucestershire, through the Cotswolds and into London itself. Passing many famous landmarks on the way. Briefly, and we've heard a snatch of the Eton boating song, and one of the games that England gave to the world, Britain gave to the world. Down past Big Ben. This is the most favourite programme in the country on television. EastEnders. Which is where we are, of course. Programmes of past games. And now London 2012. Final countdown to the striking of the bell by Bradley Wiggins.
To the Games of the 30th Olympiad. To open our ceremony, Olympic cyclist, member of Team GB and Britain's first winner of the Tour de France, Bradley Wiggins.
Just listen to the applause he's getting. The yellow jersey that he wore for most of the Tour de France. Let the games begin. London's games, but Great Britain's games. All the songs of the four countries that make up the United Kingdom.
Be not afeard. Be not afeard. The isle is full of noises, sounds and sweet airs that give delight and hurt not. Sometimes, a thousand twangling instruments will hum about mine ears, and sometime voices that if I then had waked after long sleep will make me sleep again. And then, in dreaming, the clouds methought would open and show riches ready to drop upon me, that when I waked, I cried to dream again.
Words from The Tempest by William Shakespeare. Kenneth Branagh brings to life one of the pillars of the Industrial Revolution, the civil engineer and pioneer Isambard Kingdom Brunel. Now to the increasing sound of drums of many types and many sizes, soon to be led by the remarkable Dame Evelyn Glennie, whose rhythm is found in her feet, for she's been stone deaf since birth. The revolution will be laid before your eyes, the rapid industrialization of the early days between the 18th and 19th centuries. Came from the green and pleasant land to the cities. As the scene changed, so life changed. Excitement on the one hand, fear and hardship on the other. cities and the industry would grow. Change. Later on, the suffragettes would fight for their rights. Later still, in the days early in the 20th century, war would ask an impossible price. Many who had worked together, enlisted, and died together. Fields which would be forever Britain. We'll be right back. others would come from other lands, in particular from the West Indies. Struck in the foundry was of the highest quality. And here, London in 2012, we welcome the Olympic rings to Stratford on this day. And the five continents of the world are joined above the Olympic stage. And a dramatic, very well-performed start. Segment was called Pandemonium, a word that was invented by the 17th century English poet John Milton. It's the name for the capital, the city of hell, in his epic poem, Paradise Lost. And at the moment, the feeling in the stadium was rather more of paradise found. Now, happy and glorious.
Welcome to the throne room. It's designed by John Nash. You'll notice again the favourite colours of gold, white and green, done in the red coat of each time, which Queen Victoria, of course, sold to the corporation of Brighton and made a lot of the fittings here.
James Bond, Daniel Craig.
Evening, sir.
007.
Evening.
Salute from the corpus.
Mr. Bond, Your Majesty.
Dambusters by Eric Coates. East. the way around the stadium. James Bond epic, starring Daniel Craig and Her Majesty the Queen.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous lever pour Sa Majesté la Reine et Son Altesse Royale, le Duc d'Édimbourg, accompagné par le président du Comité international olympique, Jacques Rogge.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for Her Majesty the Queen and His Royal Highness the Duke of Edinburgh, accompanied by the president of the International Olympic Committee, Jacques Rogge.
Never can Her Majesty have been introduced to her public in a manner like that. And the crowd have loved it. Celebrate Her Majesty in her Diamond Jubilee year.
Mesdames et messieurs, le drapeau du Royaume-Uni est hissé par des représentants de la Royal Navy, de l'armée de terre britannique et de la Royal Air Force.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Union flag is raised by representatives from the Royal Navy, Army and Royal Air Force.
Party under the command of Squadron Leader Lambert from RAF Brismore. Manner. This is not an easy task for members of our armed forces.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous lever pour l'hymne national du Royaume-Uni, chanté par le chœur des enfants sourds et entendants de Chaos.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem of the United Kingdom, performed by the Chaos Signing Choir for Deaf and Hearing Children.
Wonderfully done, very differently, so warm, and how nice to hear two voices, the two verses. Certainly many more than two voices. And now we move on to celebrate an institution which was founded the year of the last London Olympics in 1948. And we're going to see a very special example.
Veuillez accueillir Mike Oldfield, accompagné du personnel du National Health Service et de nos invités d'honneur, des patients et le personnel du Great Ormond Street Hospital.
Please welcome Mike Oldfield and the staff of the United Kingdom National Health Service and our very special guest this evening, patients and staff of Great Ormond Street Hospital.
Yes, certainly, as I was saying, very special hospital looking after children. And all the performers here, not Mr. Oldfield, but all those on stage dancing and looking after the children are regular members of National Health staff. Great Ormond Street Hospital, gosh. Mike Oldfield plays Tubular Bells, which is a huge hit for him. Society can legitimately call itself civilized if a sick person is denied medical aid because of lack of means. Some would prefer a bedtime story.
Of all delectable islands, Neverland is the snuggest. It's not large and sprawly, you know, with boring distances between one adventure and the next. It's nicely crammed. When you play at it by day, with the table and chairs, it's not a bit frightening. But in the 2 minutes before you go to sleep, it is real.
J.K. Rowling, the creator of Harry Potter. Some of the great villains of British literature. Literature for children. Cruella de Vil, 101 Dalmatians, Voldemort from Harry Potter, and the Child Catcher from Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. Where British creations originally. Cruella de Vil. Those unlucky children who have to be in Great Ormond Street Hospital were allowed to sit up so they can say to Nurse Damaro, I saw you on television. But they were very, very good. It worked very well, in my opinion. There are some doubts about
Mesdames
it.
Et messieurs, veuillez accueillir Sir Simon Rattle. Ce soir, en l'honneur de la cinématographie britannique, il dirigera the London Symphony Orchestra, qui interprète les chariots de feu.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Sir Simon Rattle. Tonight, as a tribute to the British film industry, he is conducting the London Symphony Orchestra in a performance of Chariots of Fire.
telling me that I was turning my microphone off. Is English humour at its best. Rowan Atkinson, Mr. Bean, famous surely all around the world, and I hope you laughed. You had a full-time job.
Mesdames et messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Rowan Atkinson.
Chariots of Fire, incidentally, is showing as a film and as a play in London currently. Now, we've had one revolution. We began with the industrial. Now, we're offered two more through music, a love story, popular culture and social attitudes, which have changed so much from the 60s, will be revealed again with much humor.
Today, apparently, a woman rang the BBC and said she heard that there was a hurricane on the way. Well, if you're watching, don't worry, there isn't.
Sardines.
Ay, abuela, no empieces, por favor.
La abuela tiene razón, hija. Hay modas y modas.
There you go, Nina. Stay, can't get me be.
Now I'm tired and hungry. I want some more.
What? Hey, absolutely. Hooray!
Everybody, gadgets down now.
Die, stupid.
I told you to put that down. Now, come on, buddy.
Son!
What we're about to receive, let us be truly thankful.
Check it. I'm a fairy black cat.
Because you're going nowhere just like that, young lady.
This is a proper skirt.
It's too short.
Wear it when I'm dead.
Go and put on a proper skirt and cool yourself.
I'll give a larger and crisps. Like when I was young, girl, I wanted to be everything on the planet.
absolutely gorgeous.
Thank you.
words of David Cassidy, in fact, while he was still with the Partridge Family, I think I love you.
I wake up, every day is a daydream. Everything in my life ain't what it seems. I wake up just to go back to sleep. I act real shallow, but I'm in too deep. And all I care about is sex and violence. A heavy baseline is my kind of silence. Everybody says that I gotta get a grip, but I let sanity give me the slip. Some people think I'm bonkers, but I just think I'm free. And I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Some people pay for thrills, but I get mine for free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me.
Bonkers.
Revolution is quite adequate.
Mesdames et messieurs, Sir Tim Berners-Lee, inventor du World Wide Web.
Ladies and gentlemen, the inventor of the World Wide Web, Sir Tim Berners-Lee.
Can we now imagine our lives without it? Or indeed, from earlier in that sequence, a mobile phone. Taken to Wendell. famous. And the not so famous. I've carried him around the land. London. She was 100 on Wednesday of this week when she carried the torch. The youngest was Dominic McGowan from Birmingham, who was 12 when he carried the flame on the 1st of July. So Bobby Charlton. It's been carried all sorts of ways. It's had a huge fire. Taken to the Queen. Going to sum up it again very short. It's been wonderful. How people wanted to touch it, be close to it, whatever their physical problems. Really has united the nation. Designed by an East London design company, Barbara Ogilvy. 8,000 holes cut in it, circles, electrical, each upper torch panels. The red arrows.
Réflexion en respect de notre mur de la mémoire pour les amis et familles de ceux présents dans le stade qui n'ont pu être ici ce soir. Merci.
Ladies and gentlemen, please pause to respect our memorial wall for friends and family of those in the stadium that cannot be here tonight. Thank you.
Different presentation of Abide With Me. sound sequences choreographed and led by Akram Khan, born in London to Bangladeshi parents, and has successfully combined classical, European and Indian forms of dance in this world. Voiced such clarity, such expression.
Mesdames et messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, Akram Khan and Emily Sande.
Beautiful.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez accueillir les athlètes des Jeux Olympiques de Londres 2012.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the athletes of the London 2012 Olympic Games.
So the start of the athletes' parade, traditionally led by Greece.
Greece!
The country of the traditional games, the country of the modern games from 1896. They've been there every time. The man carrying their flag is Alexandros Nikolaidis. Taekwondo silver medal in Athens and in Beijing.
Afghanistan.
Ancient key point of the Silk Route, connects the Middle East with Asia and India, and has been an area of such problem. Nessa Ahmed Bawi, Taekwondo, is carrying their flag.
It's their 14th appearance in the Olympic movement.
Albania!
Tension with the beat of the music is to encourage the athletes to go as quickly as they can. Romela Bejaj, weightlift European silver medal. Might be their first medalist.
Yes, 11 athletes, 5 weightlifters, 2 swimmers, 1 shooter.
Algeria!
Algeria, flag of liberation movement.
Their first gold medal won by Hasiba Boumerka of Barcelona, the women's 1500 meters. That was their first. They began competing, of course, back in 1964.
Samoa, American!
American Samoa!
They're United States nationals, but not United States citizens. It's their seventh appearance. No medals yet. They've been coming since 1988. Usually enjoy weightlifting, boxing, and athletics.
Andorra!
Andorra!
175 square miles in the Pyrenees between France and Spain. The flag dates from Napoleon III. In the team only, her 10th appearance, matching 10 winter, but
Angola.
Still no medals.
Angola!
A team of 35, it's the biggest team ever. They've never won a medal. They have women's basketball team, handball teams, canoeists, athletes, 2 swimmers.
Very colourful costume.
Antigua and Barbuda.
Antigua and Barbuda.
Daniel Bailey, 5th in the World Championships over 100 metres. Daegu last year carrying their flag. Team of 5, exactly the same number as in Beijing 4 years ago.
Argentina.
Argentina.
Flag bearer at her 4th Olympic Games. Hockey player, only player to receive the World Player of the Year award, an incredible 7 times.
Famous Aymar. Big team.
Messi, of course, won their medal for them
in Beijing, and they're not here. They've won the football many times, but they didn't qualify this time. Armenia, the crossroads of Eastern Europe and West Asia, mountainous, fifth appearance, coming since 96.
Well, the discus thrower, Faina Melnik, won gold in Munich in 1972. She was Armenian, but she was representing the Soviet Union on that occasion. This is a team of 25. They've won 9 medals overall.
Arriba!
Aruba's 7th appearance. Obviously under the flag of the Netherlands Antilles. 15 miles off the coast of Venezuela in the South Caribbean Sea.
Just 4 in the team, very small team. Only 2 went to Beijing, a swim and a judo pair.
Australia. Here's a very big team.
Yes, and very strong at swimming, led out, of course, by Lauren Jackson, 3 times silver medalist in basketball. But of course, mention should be made of Lisa Jones, who's the first Australian swimmer to compete in 4 Olympic Games here in London. James Magnussen as well, very strong swimming squad indeed.
One of the ever-presents, 27th appearance. 46 medals in Beijing, 14, 15 and 17.
413 members of their team.
Didn't quite compare with the 632 they had in their home games in Sydney. Games with Cathy Freeman among many others. Always competitive in so many sports. Once again here to enjoy themselves. Flags of sea being carried to the mountain, as it were.
Austria!
Austria, 70 strong team. It's their 26th appearance. Their last gold medals were won in 2004 in Athens. 1 silver, 2 bronze. 2 gold medalists. Sailing and a triathlon.
Well, if you don't trust the weather, you can see, but it's been kind so far, and I hope I haven't just
turned
it.
Azerbaijan!
Azerbaijan!
Elnur Mamadi carries their flag. He's competing in the judo competition.
In fact, the defending Olympic champion.
A big contest. Judo, there's no question of that. Not a former Soviet Republic, of course, in the Caucasus region of Eurasia.
Medals won since 1952, 3 of them gold, sailing, of course 2 in athletics, Pauline Davis Thompson and Tonique Williams Darling, the 400 metres in Athens in 2004, that was the last one, 26 in the team.
Kingdom near the western shores of the Persian Gulf. 8th appearance, no medals yet.
Very strong in men's and women's athletics from 800 metres right the way through to the marathon. Mariam Youssef Jamal will feature certainly in the 1500 metres here.
Bordered by India, Myanmar and the Bay of Bengal. was once East Pakistan, independence in 1971. It's their eighth appearance.
Interesting, they started their involvement with the Olympic movement in 1984, in fact, in Los Angeles.
Barbados!
And they're the trident of Britannia, the three branches of democracy, government of, for and by the people. 11th appearance, their only medal, bronze medal in the 100 metres in Sydney, but over Daley Thompson.
Belarus!
Formerly White Russia. Max Birney is the holder of their flag. 35 years old now, a great reputation in doubles play in particular.
Yes, winner of 9 Grand Slam titles. Concentrating on his doubles nowadays.
Belgium!
And the country of the president, who will be overseeing for the last time, Tia Hellebout, defending the high jump from Beijing.
Yes, and when she won her gold medal in Beijing, she was the first athletics gold medal by a Belgian woman.
It was a big surprise on that occasion, I have to tell you. Nevertheless, a team of 119, very big. Jonathan and Kevin Borlée will feature in the 400 metres in these championships.
Flag that contains more colours, 12 than any other national flag. 11th Games since Mexico in 1968 was originally British Honduras.
Benin!
Flag dates back to 1959. Used to compete as Dahomey. Did so in 1972. Now their 10th appearance, 9 of them as Benin. No medals, any hopes?
Bermuda!
There are only 3 competitors in that team. It's tough.
Bermuda, 17th appearance, first in 1936, didn't go in 80 like many other countries. One bronze to their credit for a boxer. Super heavyweight too. Clarence Hill in Montreal in 1976. And they are wearing their shorts.
Well, that is their tradition, of course.
Bhutan!
Bhutan, a kingdom landlocked in the eastern Himalayas. Their name means Land of the Dragon.
Well, I'll tell you, they've only competed in archery since they were first represented in Los Angeles in 1984. They've got a team of 2 here. A different sport too.
Air rifle. Bolivia!
Back of Bolivia, carried by Claudia Valderrama. She was second in the 20-kilometer walk at the South American Championships in 2010. I don't know where that puts her. A contender here, not too far up I shouldn't think, but it's the greater importance of taking part. A lot of these athletes we're looking at won't go away with medals, but they go away with many memories. Bosnia and Herzegovina, triangular shaped in the Balkan Peninsula, they were the hosts of the 1984 Winter Games, 6th appearance now.
They've got a marathon runner in this men's shot put, judo player, shooter, individual medley in the park in the pool. A very mixed team, as many of these teams are.
Well, the next team, Botswana, 38 of their 49 medals have come from athletics. 9th appearance since 1980, but they still don't have a medal to their credit.
Well, Amantha Moncho is the real favourite, one of the 3 favourites for the 400 metres in these championships. She's only been beaten once this year by Britain's Christina Horrigan, the defending 400 metre champion.
Brazil! Brazil!
He'll be the host next time around, Rodrigo Pessoa, 39 years old, 6 Olympic Games, show jumping gold in Athens.
Yes, and following in his father's footsteps, because of course his father, Nelson Pessoa, 2-time Olympian.
And look at all the footballers who've played for them in the Olympics. Gerson, Romario, Bebeto, Ronaldo and Ronaldinho. It's a good start for putting a team together. People forget Carlos Tevez scored the winning goal back in 2004 for Argentina.
Remember Jochen Cruz too, gold in the men's 800 in 84, silver in 88. One of the greats.
Yes.
British Virgin Islands.
St. Ursula and the Lamps. Sorry, I'm trying that again. St. Ursula and the Lamps of 30 Virgins. That's their flag, adopted on November the 15th, 1960. 30 appearances, but no medals.
Brunei Darussalam.
Participated in the Olympic Games in 88 with a single official and no athletes. Team of three this time, women's 400 metres, men's 400 and the men's 200 metres freestyle. So three athletes there.
And that was Mazia Mahusin, who was carrying the flag in the women's 400 metres. Bulgaria, gymnast Jordan Yovchev, four-time Olympic medalist.
His sixth Olympic Games.
Bulgarian athletes have won a total of 218 medals incidentally, wrestling and weightlifting, the top medal producing sport.
Yes, 36 medals, 12 of them gold in weightlifting.
Burkina Faso!
Burkina Faso!
Oh, dear. Sorry, I was reacting to the pronunciation. Land of honorable men, it means, it used to be called Upper Volta.
Five competitors again. There are lots of small teams, as one would expect. As we said earlier, some will come for the experience only.
Burundi!
Burundi!
Stars on the flag for the three main ethnic groups. That's Venuste Diongabo. 5,000 metres.
Yeah, she became the Burundi's first Olympic champion.
Beijing. This is now their fifth appearance since 96.
Gombodge!
Cambodia!
Eighth appearance, no medals. That shows the Hindu temple of Angkor Wat. The king chosen by a royal throne council. Gas below their territorial waters too.
All their team out there, it's two athletes, one judo player, two swimmers, one taekwondo player.
Cameroon!
Cameroon!
Annabelle Ali, freestyle wrestler, quarterfinals in Beijing. Women play Great Britain in the football tomorrow in Cardiff.
Well, they had an Olympic champion in the triple jump in 2008, Francois Mbango.
Canada!
Oh, the Canadian team containing Ian Miller, who of course is breaking a record, his 10th Olympic Games. Absolutely extraordinary. And had it not been for the boycott, perhaps in 1980, he may have been making his 11th Olympic appearance. Equestrian rider, of course, Ian Miller. Clara Hughes is also in the Canadian team, and it should be noted that this is her sixth Olympic Games and the only athlete to be a multi-medalist in both summer and winter games. Cycling here in London, speed skater in the winter games.
Kate Purdy!
Followed by Kate Purdy, 10 islands in the Atlantic off the northwest coast of Africa.
Well, four of Cape Verde's six Olympians, that's to date, have competed as athletes. In fact, this team, two athletes and one judo player, all three in the team.
Brent Fraser, swimmer, carries the flag of the Cayman Islands, British Overseas Territory.
Republic
Central African Republic!
highest densities of lowland gorillas to be found in their country, and elephants in the forests. 9 appearances since 1984. They've been coming without success in terms of medals. Like, very like Romania. The only difference, blue is a bit darker. Best appearance, no medals.
21 of their 24 competitors in previous Olympics have been track and field athletes. This time, there are 2 athletes and 1 judo player.
Chile!
Chile!
Denise Van Lerman carries their flag. World champion in archery in Turin last year. She gets on the way tomorrow.
Chile's first gold medals came in the space of, what, less than 24 hours at the Athens Games. And they've won a total of 13 medals in all. Tennis and boxing, the top medal producers, of course.
République Populaire de Chine!
People's Republic of China!
Well, they had 639 for their own games.
383, I make it, on this occasion, much, much reduced. And of course, they came into the games in 1954 and came back into the games in Los Angeles in 1984 when others boycotted.
There's their flag bearer, Yi Jian Lian, basketball player, his 3rd Olympic Games, but for all their medals throughout their Olympic history, they have never won a gold in men's swimming. All that could change in London, because Sun Yang is one of the favourites for a gold medal in the pool.
It's interesting they've chosen the basketball player again, because it was Yao Ming in Beijing.
Very strong in table tennis as well, of course, won all individual and team medals 4 years ago.
It's the 18th appearance of Colombia, incidentally. Began in 1932. Teams won 11 medals. All that's boxing, shooting, athletics, weightlifting, cycling and wrestling. And in Sydney, a weightlifter, Tier, won Colombia's first and remains only Olympic gold medal.
First time we've got a little bit of a hold up.
It's happened in every Olympic Games I've witnessed over the last 9 Olympics, and it's bound to happen. But it is a marvellous display of young, athletic sportsmen and women.
Islands, the Indian Ocean between Mozambique and Madagascar. It's their 5th games, no medals yet. The most southerly country in the Arab League.
Congo!
Congo!
Flag dates to 1958, restored after 22 years of communist rule in 1991. 9th appearance. Came first in Tokyo in 1964. He stood astride the equator.
Cook Islands!
Cook Islands, sighted by Cook, British explorer, in 1770, the flag from 1779. 7th appearance, the first in 1988.
2 athletes, 1 canoeist. 2 canoeists actually, 1 sailor, 2 swimmers and a weightlifter make up their team.
Canada climbing the hill. Again, another copper petal about which we'll hear more later.
Costa Rica!
Gabriela Trana from Athletics carries the flag.
Yes, indeed. It's Claudia Paul of Costa Rica who has won all their medals. In fact, their one sister won 3, the other sister won.
Côte d'Ivoire!
It's a marvellous family achievement.
Creux d'Ivoire, Gabriel Aure, again athletics. Back to 1959, they had 12 games and got one silver medal.
Gabriel Tio in the 400 meters in Los Angeles. Croatia, Goran Izovic, Ivanisevic, I should say, Wimbledon champion from 2001. Competed in four Olympic Games, 88 to 2000. And of course, the team have won 17 medals to date, three gold in handball and weightlifting.
A flag carried by a member of the Olympic champion team of 1996 and 2004, Vinio Lossert.
Cuba!
Jane Lopez, he's a big fella to move along. He got gold in Greco-Roman wrestling in Beijing. And, they have 67 gold. And this is their 19th appearance.
Yes, 32 of their gold medals have actually been in boxing. And whilst they didn't win any gold in boxing in Beijing, have high hopes this time.
Let's just mention Teofilo Stevenson, who was their great boxer, who died earlier this year. This is Marcus Baghdatis. If you're a tennis fan, you'd have recognised him. Once runner-up in the Australian Open, always competitive, always fun, always passionate. Ninth appearance. They started in Moscow in 1980.
Republic!
Czech Republic! Badminton player here, Jill?
Yes, Peter Kukal, recovering from cancer. Done an awful lot back in his home country to make people aware of the dangers and, of course, set up a foundation as well. He's five times national badminton champion. It really is a delight to see him looking so fit and well.
History, Emil Zatopek, Jan Zalesny won the Olympic javelin three times. And they have a potential champion this time, Barbara Spotakova.
Democratic People's Republic of Korea, known to most of the world as North Korea. New leader, of course, since the last Olympic Games, Kim Jong-un. His father, ninth appearance, 41 medals, 10 of them gold. Up goes the flag of China to the hill.
Democratic Republic of the Congo.
Another small team, one boxer, one judo player.
Mike Barrow will be in the men's marathon. Ilunga Mende Zatara.
Yes, I missed him.
We don't when he's running. Denmark, Kim Ray Knudsen, 1,000 meter K2 canoe sprint. Biggest team since Atlanta they have.
Yeah, they've got 115 members in it. They've won 171 medals. Sailing's their top medal producing sport. More recently, handball and rowing have produced medals as well.
Yes, I think the men's handball team have a really good chance this year. They're the European champions.
Djibouti's eighth appearance. Used to be French Somalia, northeast of the Gulf of Aden.
Just one bronze medal. The marathon in 1988 in Seoul. Hussein Ahmed Salah has got six athletes this time, six competitors.
Flag which features on the flag of Dominica is the Cicero Parrot, their national emblem. It's got a slight glimpse of it in the middle. Fifth games, no medals. 10 of 13 Olympians in athletics and three swimmers.
Dominica Dominican Republic have won two golds, one in Athens in 2004 and one in Beijing 4 years ago. First Olympic champion was Felix Sanchez. He won gold in the 400 metre hurdles in Athens. He runs again here in London. Also got a boxer, Felix Diaz, won gold in the men's lightweight welterweight division in Beijing 4 years ago too.
Ecuador, Condor on it, poised, 13th appearance, one gold medal in 1996 and one silver in 2008 in the 20-kilometre walk, both by the same man, Jefferson Perez.
Egypt!
Flag of Egypt. Member of the Maktoum family in his fourth games.
They're very big in weightlifting, five gold medals in weightlifting, two in wrestling, silvers and bronzes in diving, weightlifting again, wrestling, judo, boxing and taekwondo. Good range of sports.
El Salvador!
El Salvador!
Salvador's flag carried by a cyclist, Evelyn Garcia. Appearance for the country, smallest and most densely populated country in Central America.
Equatorial
Guinea. Eighth game since 1984, and a famous swimmer here.
Well, yes, Eric Musambani. Remember Eric the Eel?
Eritrea.
Game for Eritrea. Another 11 athletes in Beijing.
Estonia!
Alexander Temert carries the flag of Estonia. 2004 discus bronze, the age of 39 now.
Yes, appearing in his fourth Olympics.
Gerd Kanter is certainly one of the five favourites to defend his title here in the discus. Ethiopia, Abebe Bikila, Mama Walde, Miris Yifta, Girata Tulu, Haile Gebrselassie, Kenenisa Bekele. You could go on and on and on with their magnificent athletics teams over the years. There are 35 members in this team, 33 athletes and 2 swimmers.
Fiji!
800 plus volcanic and coral islands. Flag carried by Yositeki Natu, who is a judoka. Came into the games in Montreal for the first time in 1976.
Finland.
Anyone challenging in their best?
Finnish athletes have enjoyed long-term success in athletics and wrestling, and they've recently had some impressive performance in the shooting discipline. And we've got, of course, remember Paavo Nurmi in the past, Lasse Vierat, and Tero Pitkämäki, the javelin thrower, will be appearing here as well.
Marko Lazewski, swimmer, carries their flag. One bronze in freestyle wrestling in Sydney. That's the only medal they have. And this is their fifth appearance. Like stylized sun rays.
France!
La Belle France. Well, they thought it was going to be there, didn't they? Maybe the time will come. Instead, it's here in London. Laura Nessel. Two fencing gold medals, 96, we've got 5 medals in total.
We just had a glimpse there of Teddy Riner, the heavyweight judo player, hot favourite. He's lost just 2 fights in the last 4 years.
Gabon!
French one of the ever countries. Gabon, they're making their ninth appearance.
Romanian football, Terry, and the two athletes and two boxers, one judo player and one taekwondo player. So 28 strong in for the team.
We've had just three presidents over a spell of 52 years since independence, which is different from some countries. The Gambia, smallest country in mainland Africa, surrounded by Senegal. Eighth appearance, no medals.
Yeah, just a team of two athletes, the women's 100 meters and the men's 100
meters. Nino Selakbetse, pistol shooter at the age of 43, seventh Olympic Games, got a gold in 88 he did.
Oh, I remember the triple jumper Viktor Saniyev, Georgia's most successful competitor in athletics. World record to win his first gold in Mexico in 68, high Olympic Games.
Germany!
Flag of Germany being waved in style by Natasha Keller. Extraordinary family of hockey. She had a grandfather who won a silver medal, a father won a gold medal, and three brothers have won at least one gold medal each in the sport. She's still key for her country's hopes.
Yep. Yes, Germany also very strong in the equestrian events, and Peter Jopek in fencing, five times world champion, looking for his elusive Olympic gold medal.
Oh, I hope he gets it.
398 members of the German team.
Actually, the smallest since reunification. To Ghana, made their debut at the Olympics in 1952 as the Gold Coast. Now their 13th appearance, no gold medals, but silver in 1960 and two bronze in boxing. And they've had a useful football team in 1992.
Grenada!
Well, Grenada, eight athletes, one swimmer, one taekwondo player. Remember, Kirani James, in the 400 meters, he's the world champion. He's one of the main contenders here. Can't wait to see that race. 10 teams, 10 members of the team in all there. Eighth appearance.
Guam.
Seventh appearance of little Guam. Once won Miss World, I remember. Largest of the Mariana Islands, east of the Philippines, south of Japan, West Pacific. 11 appearances, no medals yet. Juan Ignacio Migli, who's a sailor. This is not too rough tonight for him to carry the flag.
19 members of the team, three athletes, a badminton player, a cyclist, a gymnast, a judo player, a multi-event athlete, a couple of sailors and shooters, a swimmer, a taekwondo player, and two weightlifters, so that's well spread.
Followed by Guinea, making their 10th appearance. Footballers first, they made their debut in 1968. Of autocratic leaders and turbulent classes, 24 ethnic groups in that country. Guinea-Bissau, West Africa, bordered by Senegal, Guinea and the Atlantic.
Yeah, big gap between 1968 and 80. They started in Mexico City and then came back in Moscow in 1980. What a team of four here.
Winston George in the 400 metres carries the flag for Guyana, the only English-speaking country in South America. Land of many waters, north of the Amazon, east of the Orinoco. Haiti, 14th appearance.
Yes, indeed. Long jump, silver medalist in Amsterdam in 1928. had a couple of medals, a bronze in 1924 for shooting, and a team of five this time.
Carried for Honduras by Ronald Bennett, three times the 110-meter hurdles champion of Central America. Team of 25 in Beijing. And here,
31.
Hong Kong, Xin!
Hong Kong, China!
Hong Kong, China, flag carried by BYC cyclist. Of course, upset the defending Olympic champion, Victoria Pendleton, in the Olympic test event here in the London Velodrome.
Most of the equestrian part of the Olympics last time round. Peter Biros, gold in the last three water polo wins for Hungary. 2000, 2004, 2008. That is their favourite sport.
They had a very, very good javelin throw in Miklos Nemeth too, the Montreal champion. Father Imrie, of course, began the family tradition. The gold in the 1948 London Games here.
Iceland!
19th appearance for Iceland, Nordic Ireland and the North Atlantic. Hot springs and active volcanoes as we knew to our cost when the planes were grounded.
Yes, indeed, this team's got 21 members. First Olympic medal came in Melbourne in 1956. Johanbjørn Einarsson, who took silver in the men's triple jump.
Independent Olympic athlete.
The Independent Olympic Athletes team, the executive board of the IOC, has authorised certain athletes to compete as individuals at the London Games. And there are three from the Netherlands Antilles and one from Sudan.
South Sudan,
yes.
India!
Here come the Indians.
There's some real medal chances for India. There's a real character in the women's boxing. Mary Kom, mother of two twins, she has, and in Manipur, she really is the favourite. Three times world champion, and of course, India have high hopes of Saina Nehwal in the badminton competition as well.
And it's good to see their hockey team back.
Indonesia.
Siman Sudatawa, swimmer in a team of 22 for Indonesia.
Actually, at the Melbourne Games, the Indonesian team featured women for the first time, both competing in the swimming event.
Well, they have a total of six gold medals, all of them from badminton.
Islamic Republic of Iran!
I didn't think you'd miss that, Joe. So, Iran follow, Ali Mazahiri, a boxer in his second games, number 53. Rob is great, is written on the flag 22 times.
Iraq!
I'm on the flag of Iraq, sorry, I shouldn't laugh. God is good, is written only once, but larger. 12th appearance, the first in London in 1948. I've only been regular since 1980.
Ireland!
Iraq compared to Ireland. Their first appearance in 1924. Michelle Smith winning three gold medals in swimming in 1996.
Betty Taylor, women's boxing. World titles in the arena.
Israel!
Team from Israel. 15th appearance.
Actually, Israel won its first Olympic medal only in its 10th Olympic appearance in judo at the Barcelona Olympic Games in 1992.
Italy!
Valentina Vizzali from fencing carries the medal. I hope she does for her sake. Carries the flag, that's what I was trying to say.
Yeah, she's competing in her fifth games, and in fact, she's medalled at all her four previous games. Great record.
curious that their flag dates from Napoleon's invasion. Always found that a bit amusing.
Well, they've won 228 gold medals, which makes them the fourth most successful country in Olympic history in terms of gold medals. Remember Dorando Pietri, 1908? Sorry, Barry, 1908.
Yes, I was going to let it pass. Federica Pellegrini in the 400 metres free in the pool. He's certainly a challenger for Britain's Trevor Adlington.
Jamaica!
Jamaica!
Well, a Jamaican team is led by a man walking. He never walked. Usain Bolt, the greatest, the world champion, the Olympic champion, the world record holder, 100, 200, 4x100 meters relay. Remember, it started with Arthur Wint. He was their first Olympic champion. Don Quarry came
in
along.
London. That,
yes, it was.
Japan! Japan!
Sayori Yoshida, double gold medalist, a wrestler.
Nine times world champion. In fact, she's won every world and international level event that she's ever entered since 2002. That's 10 years winning everything she's entered. My piece of evidence, a hot favourite. It's Kohei Uchimura, also in the gymnastics, a hot favourite.
Taekwondo players. Shooting and athletics have provided most of their Olympic representations. First Jordanian woman to compete in Los Angeles in 84 for 3,000 metres.
Kazakhstan!
Reda Adala.
Kazakhstan, the world's largest landlocked country. Bigger than the whole of Western Europe. The wrestler carries their flag. Numakan Dinaliev. Legs mounting up at the mount. Another big athletics team coming next.
Kenya!
Kenya!
Well, Kenya, 21 gold medals since 1968 when Timu Kaino and B Watt began it all. 20 in athletics and one in boxing, it's a team of 50. And of course, David Rudisha, the biggest favourite in the 800 metres here in these championships.
But not carrying the flag, he was supposed to. Jason Dunford carried it. He's in the 100 metres. Here is Kiribati, in spite of the spelling of the name. Third games, no medals. And three to Athens, two to Beijing, and now three again.
Absolutely. They've got a women's 100 metres and the men's 100 metres and a weightlifter as well.
Republic of Korea!
Now, South Korea, as we tend to call it.
And Korea very strong in archery and combat sports, wrestling, judo and taekwondo. In fact, in archery, and they've won every team gold in the women's competition, team competition, since it first came into the Olympics in 1988.
Since taekwondo was introduced in 2000, Koreans have won every gold medal in that too, in the men's heavyweight and the women's featherweight division. So they've dominated a couple of sports there.
Kuwait, 11 athletes, including two women. Their 12th appearance. One bronze medal in the double trap in Sydney.
Kyrgyzstan!
Kyrgyzstan!
That's shooting, in case you don't know. Tajikistan.
14 in this team. The medals have come from judo and wrestling. First Olympic medal came in Sydney 2000. Smagula took bronze in the men's extra lightweight.
Republic Democratic Populaire
Laos! Laos People's Democratic Republic!
Very small team for Laos as well, with just three. men's and women's 100 metres, and a swimmer as well in men's 50 metres freestyle. 40 Olympians from Laos over the years, competing, most of them competing in
Italy.
Martins Lovins, beach volleyball and horse guards parade. Carrying the flag for Latvia.
Only two gold medals actually over the years.
Lebanon!
Gymnastics and cycling.
And you have to say they are keeping them at a very good pace. 16th appearance for Lebanon. Two silver, two bronze. Three from wrestling and one from weightlifting. But they haven't won anything since 1980.
Lesotho!
Lesotho!
10th appearance, no medals yet. Four in team and two of them are in the marathon.
Yes, indeed. Men's and women's marathon represented here, the men's 200 metres and the women's 50 metres freestyle.
Liberia! Liberia!
Now their flag is carried by Obe Kutu Akoi in the 100 metres. She's known as Speedy, but she went out in the heats of the World Championship. Tell me more.
No, no, there's no more to say. Came into the Olympic movement in 1956.
Libya!
10th appearance for Libya. Still waiting and hoping and competing.
Libya's first Olympic competitor, the 400-meter hurdler, Mohamed Wai Aswadi
Khalifa.
Liechtenstein. Stephanie Vogt, who's in the low 200s on the women's computer in the world of tennis. Lithuania. Vagilius Alekna, double Olympic champion with discus.
Yes, he is, and he's one of the favourites again this year. He's in very good form.
How was his pronunciation?
Alekna, very good. The first, the Christian name, not so sure.
Madagascar!
Got rather quickly past Luxembourg. See much of Marie Muller. Now here's Madagascar.
Remember, in Mexico, Jean Gil Ravalomanosoa, the 100 metres, reached the men's final. He's also the first to Madagascar to take part in three Olympic Games from 1964 to 1976.
Certainly a bit testing for a commentator.
Malawi!
Malawi!
Ninth appearance for Malawi. That breaks the world records, the speed of the athletes around the track and the open terminals.
Well, Malaysia have competed in 19 Olympic sports. All their medals have come in badminton.
Yes, indeed. Two silver and two bronze. And of course, the world number one, Lee Chong Wei, is recovering from injury, so desperate to win their first ever gold medal.
All thieves. 20 miles southwest of Sri Lanka, been a regular since Seoul in 1988.
Mali!
Mali!
Team of six from Mali, two athletes, one judo player, a couple of swimmers, and a taekwondo player, came into the games in 64. They've never won an Olympic medal.
It's the home of Timbuktu, but it's not part of the happy country as it used to be. Malta. William Chetkuti, men's gravel cup shooting.
In 1948, there was just one lone Maltese competitor, Nestor Cecconi, took part in the men's 100
metres. Il Marshall!
Marshall Island!
I hadn't realised you were there, Steve. Marshall Islands made their debut in Beijing and they're here again. There's four in their team.
Two athletes, two swimmers.
Female side.
Mauritania!
Islamic colours on the flag of Mauritania, former French colony, independent in 1960. 8 games from 1984, no medals. 2 more athletes.
The same as in Beijing. 2 in Beijing. First representative of Los Angeles is displayed by 2 wrestlers.
Mauritius. 8 games, they've got 1 bronze. It's in Beijing. Bruna Juli. Bantamweight. Again. They are going to be very important.
Mexico!
Mexico. Maria Espinosa. Gold in Taekwondo.
Quite a reasonable sized team, 106. 12 gold medals so far between 1948 and 2008. Both Mexico's gold medals in Beijing were in Taekwondo.
Federated States of Micronesia.
There were 600 islands in the Southwest Pacific, covering 270 square miles. Fourth appearance in the Olympics, started in Sydney. Six in their team.
Provided most of the country's medals, I have to say. The first Mongolian woman to win an Olympic medal was a pistol shooter in Barcelona in 1992.
Montenegro!
Montenegro!
Montenegro made their debut in Beijing. They've established as a separate country. Sedan Bavalovic. Judo. Number 4th in the water polo in Beijing, so they've got hopes there.
Morocco!
13th appearance for Morocco.
Remember, Morocco's first gold medal was won by Noel El Moutawakel in the women's 400 meter hurdles in the Los Angeles Olympics. She's now a member of the IOC. Saida Rita Rahim Boutayeb. 10,000 meter gold in 1980 against Khalid Scar. Some wonderful names in Moroccan athletics over the years in particular.
Very smart. Kuto carries their flag, he's in the 400 metres hurdles.
And it's an athlete, Maria Matola, of course, who earned both Mozambique's Olympic medals to date. In 2000, she became her country's first Olympic champion.
Myanmar,
former Burma, 16th appearance. And they're another country who first came to the Olympic party in London.
Namibia!
And the world came together again after the Second World War. Namibia, Gabby Arends, her second game. She's a trap shooter.
Yes, and a total of 4 Olympic medals for Namibia. 4 silvers and all 4 won by Frankie Fredericks. 100 and 200 metre runner, of course.
Famous moments, particularly in Atlanta. He followed Michael Johnson in.
Followed by Nauru.
Nepal!
Nepal!
Fifth appearance. And very quickly on to Nepal.
Just 5 in the team.
Rashida Yung-Cha, 50 metres freestyle. In the second games.
Netherlands, Manabakis Kern, Anton Giesing. There are some names that we all remember in Olympic history here. First competed in Paris in 1900. First gold medal came in the rowing ox pairs. 25th appearance in the Olympic Games.
Here are the Kiwis, famous names in their past too, like Peter Snell and John Walker.
Murray Halberg and Jack Lovelock even earlier.
Yes. And Mark Toddy's still around with equestrian.
197 members of the team, so it's a fair-sized team for the All Blacks.
Yes, you mentioned Mark Todd, of course, this is his 7th Olympic Games.
New Zealand started in 1908. In London. Nicaragua, Michelle Richardson, silver for the United States in 84. Now back to her native country. Nisha follow quickly. Their 11th appearance, 1 bronze medal in boxing, Isaka Dabora. The orange in the flag represents the Sahara, which is about 80% of the country.
Nigeria!
Nigeria then, 2 gold medals since 1964. Chioma Ajumwa in the long jump, and of course the football team winning in Atlanta in 1996. Team of 53, 15th appearance, came in 1952. Incidentally, Ajumwa was the first Nigerian to win an individual gold medal.
Norway!
From Norway, who suffered the sudden death of Alexander Delerin, 26-year-old swim champion. Norway, a country that, in my opinion, produced the best winter games ever in Lillehammer.
Oh, man.
4 medals in winter games and in summer, but even so, done well enough with 44 medals.
Oman with 3 athletes, 1 shooter, no medal so far. Entered the games in 1984, so this is their 8th appearance.
There's just 1 woman in the team. Oman.
Pakistan!
Pakistan! Well, Pakistan for 20 years dominated field hockey. No medal in the sport since 1992. They won bronze. Team of 23, they've got a couple of athletes this time. A complete hockey squad, it's a big squad. 1 shooter, 2 swimmers. They've been represented in every Olympic hockey tournament. It's their big, big sport.
They're now ranked only 8.
Palau!
Palau!
Palau. Flag of the full moon over the northern Pacific. 4th games. Debut in Sydney.
Palestine!
Palestine!
Team of 5, 2 athletes, 1 judo player and 2 swimmers. 10,000 metre runner, Majed Nabu Mathil, gained their first Olympian, as their only competitor in Atlanta. Came in 1996.
Panama Games, yes.
Panama!
Lastly recognised by the UN and the IOC. We've been happy to have the Olympics since 1995. Panama followed.
Saladino, their men's long jump Olympic champion, will defend his title here.
Papua New Guinea!
Papua New Guinea, their ninth, their first in Montreal in 76.
And a team of just eight competitors this time.
Like to have different emblems on the obverse and reverse sides.
The nation's only ever won one medal, silver in the men's football in 2004, but they lost 1-0 to Argentina in the final, the Athens final. Entered the games in 1964 in Tokyo.
Jeda carries the flag of Peru. Machu Picchu and the Inca City in the Andes.
They won a total of four medals, three in shooting, one in women's volleyball,
Philippines!
Shooting gold in 1948 back here in London.
Philippines. First medal was a bronze in swimming in 1928. They've had eight more since. 20th appearance.
Athletics, their most successful sport.
Yes, and the flag carried by Agnieszka Wanska.
There is, forgive me for interrupting, that was Alina Szabinska, one of the greats in Polish athletics.
Polish men's volleyball team, a very good chance of a medal here in London.
Portugal!
Portugal!
European judo champion Thelma Montero, three world silver medals to her credit. There is their flag, a team of 80.
Carlos Lopez, Rosa Mota, Fernando Ribeiro, Nelson Ibora, all great gold medalists for Portugal.
Puerto Rico!
Puerto Rico, flag carried by Javier Colson. 100-meter hurdler, looking for his country's first ever Olympic medal.
Yeah, he's unbeaten this year. Di Green is his Great Britain is his nearest competitor.
Qatar!
Qatar! Qatar, the home of World Cup finals in the not too distant future. Eighth appearance in the Olympic Games. The bronze medals to their credit.
For the first time, they've sent female athletes to the Olympic Games this year.
The IOC have insisted on that, haven't they? Romania, Maria Teco, 27-year-old tennis player, who has been unlucky enough to lose three consecutive Wimbledon doubles finals. This year, he lost to the British. Jonathan Murray and Robert Lindstedt of Denmark. And here are the Russians, a big team again.
The Russian Federation, of course, coming with a team of 437. They've won a total of, 322 medals at the Summer Olympics since 1996 Atlanta, so...
Yes, and the flag carried by Maria Sharapova, current world number one tennis player.
We'll note that we're often seeing the leaders of the countries as the teams come by, but to be perfectly frank, we try to get their names in as well as those of the team, and the pace that we're going is pretty well impossible. And I use that as an excuse to make the mistake about the number of medals won by Norway, for which my apologies.
Rwanda, seven competitors, three athletes, one cyclist, mountain biker, judo player and two swimmers, came into the games in Los Angeles in 84. I tell you at this stage there are still 61 teams to come in, this just shows how enormous the games have become.
St. Kitts and Nevis!
And now here's an old friend of yours, Stuart.
Yes indeed, Kim Collins competes in his fifth Olympics, twice reached the Olympic 100 metre final, former world champion, a really nice chap, he's an ambassador for St. Kitts and Nevis. They even have a national holiday in his honour.
St. Lucia!
Fifth games for St. Lucia.
Team of four here. Came in 96, so they've participated four times. Small team.
St. Vincent and the Grenadines.
Team of just three here in London. One swimmer.
One athlete, one canoeist, one judo player, two taekwondo players, and as you see, two weightlifters.
San Marino, the oldest republic in the world. Alessandro Parilli is in their shooting team.
Sao Tome e Principe!
Sao Tome e Principe!
San Marino, incidentally, only a population of 31,500, so. You know, a team of four is a pretty good representation, really, compared with some of the big teams like India.
Have a quick look at La Camilla Quaresma.
Saudi Arabia.
Sultan Mubarak Al Dawoodi from Athletics carries their flag. 10th appearance since Munich in 1972.
Team of 19, only two women in the team, the 800 metres and the judo team as well.
That's their background on the debate.
Senegal
have got off to a good start before the opening ceremony by holding the Great Britain team in the men's football.
Only medal at Seoul in 1988 in 400 metre hurdles. El Amadou Diaba.
Lovely shade of yellow. Very, very colourful as it usually is.
Serbia!
So there's a famous face.
Djokovic.
You can see he's loving it.
We got a bronze in 2008 in Beijing, of course.
Certainly among the favourites, Novak for the tennis. Roger Federer there too, and one or two other big names, but not Nadal because he's not fit. Which is a shame.
Seychelles, just six competitors, a couple of athletes, a boxer, a judo player, two swimmers. Entered the games in 1980 in Moscow. Competed in all the games since then. It's their ninth appearance then.
Sierra Leone!
Hola, Santa Cese. Appearing in this Olympic stadium, Felix.
Singapore,
where the decision was made 7 years ago to bring the games to London.
Two silver medals in weightlifting and table tennis. For the first one in 1960, they had to wait right the way through to Beijing in 2008 for the second medal, which was the table tennis medal.
Table tennis player. great. Can't wait. In fact, second games where Singapore has had a women's table tennis player. One gold and one bronze in the course of that athlete to win an individual swimming gold.
Suriname, incidentally, were the 175th team to pass the dais.
Sweden!
Swaziland go by. Africa. Swaziland follow, Luke Hall from the World of Aquatics. Ninth appearance for the country, no medals.
Sweden, remember, hosted the games in 1912.
Sweden!
Switzerland!
This is a nice touch for Switzerland. The flag is carried by Stanislas Wawrinka. Spends his life being number two to Roger Federer in his country. Sometimes gives him quite a battle. And I suppose he's the contender here.
Well, they've won 48 gold medals in Olympic history. Roger Federer and Stanislas Wawrinka, as you say, they won the double in Beijing.
Syrian Arab Republic.
Yes, they did. So Mr. Federer wants the singles this time round. Syria, Majed Aldin Ghazal, men's high jump in his second games. The country in turmoil.
Chinese Taipei!
Chinese Taipei!
This is their eighth appearance, incidentally, as Taipei, as Chinese Taipei. Began in 1980 under that heading. They didn't compete actually there. They started their new life, so to speak, in 1984. A team of 45 here.
Yeah, some 4 years ago, four bronze medals for Chinese Taipei, two in taekwondo and two in weightlifting.
Chi Cheng was the first female athlete to win a medal, Olympic medal for Chinese Taipei.
Lady carrying the flag here is a boxer, Mavzuna Koryeva. That's the flag of Tajikistan. Fifth appearance, first in 1996. First medals in Beijing, silver in wrestling, bronze in judo.
Republic Unie de Tanzanie!
United Republic of Tanzania!
Tanzania, Zakia Marisho. Flag.
Two medals, two silvers, Gilbert Bailly in the 3,000 metre steeplechase, Nayam Bui in the 5,000 in 1980, both in 1980 in Moscow.
Yes, Gilbert Bailly denied his opportunity to run against John Walker in Montreal.
Thailand's 21 Olympic medals in total. And all of them in just three sports: boxing, weightlifting, and taekwondo.
Timor-Leste!
Very small team, just two competitors, both marathon runners. They ran, or they competed in 2000 as individual athletes, incidentally. This is their third Olympics, but two by right.
Another canoeist carrying the flag. It's time for Togo, Benjamin Petty. They won bronze, which they won last time out, in canoeing. Men's slalom.
Tonga!
Tonga!
Amini Kandua, swimmer in the 100 meters breaststroke.
Trinidad and Tobago,
Mark Burns, World of Athletics.
I remember that day, Barry, when Hazley Crawford in Montreal was my first Olympics in the commentary box, and the men's 100 metres, great run. They've got a team of 31 here, and began their Olympic journey in 1948, incidentally.
Tunisia!
Good goal. And there go them. And the men's basketball team. Also played for Tunisia.
70 medals won so far since 1960, two of them gold.
Moody and Maluli, the 5,000 and the 1,500 metre freestyle at the pool, respectively.
There's Sama Belusi defends the 1500. He's also competing in the open water. Turkey, or as they like it to call, Turkey. Leslie Handemir Vanel, women's volleyball team. Where's their flag?
Looking at the figures, wrestling, they've won 28 gold medals in wrestling and 8 in weightlifting. They've far outstrip every other sport. They've got 1 in judo, the rest have come in, it's mainly wrestling.
Turkmenistan! Fifth games for Turkmenistan.
Actually, no athlete representing Turkmenistan has won an Olympic medal. It's the only former Soviet republic not to do so.
Maybe it will change this time. Yeah.
Tuvalu!
Tuvalu!
8 stars on the flag for all the islands. Means 8 together. Only their second games. Beijing, they had 3 athletes, 2 sprinters, men and women, and 1 weightlifter. Weightlifter is carrying the flag here. La Bois.
Uganda, all of their athletics in, all of their medals, I should say, in athletics and boxing. John Akibua, 1972, men's 400 metre hurdles. Terrific run. Broke David Henry, Great Britain's world record at that time. 47.8, I remember it well.
Ukraine!
Haven't won a medal since their bronze in 96. Ukraine, Roman Gontiuk, twice a judo medalist, is their flag bearer.
Budka in the foreground.
Oh, yeah.
Broke the world record in the pole vault, I believe, 35 times.
Struggled to win an Olympic medal. He really did. He was world champion so many times and really found it difficult. Just underlines how different the Olympic Games is to every other competition. It's very, very special.
Four more medals to make it 100. Here are the United Arab Emirates. Sheikh Saeed bin Maktoum Al Maktoum in his 4th games. He's in the skeet shoot. 8th appearance, 1 medal. Gold in Athens. This was by Ahmed Al Maktoum. Also in shooting, and in trap shooting. United States of America. Daniel Zagunis, fencer, carries their flag. Gold in the sabre in Athens and Beijing, and the First Lady of America leads the applause for the United States team, who will have chances all over the place.
Well, they have many on the track in every respect. Let me just tell you, they've got 2,298 medals in the Summer Olympic history. It's quite extraordinary. First Lady enjoying these moments. Wonderful, wonderful team. Michael Phelps goes for only 7 events this time. Remember, he got 8 gold medals last time.
And what about the contests in the pool?
Ryan Lochte is the other great swimmer. It's going to be not going to be easy. There's a very big green team basketball team wandering amongst the crowd there. Some of the big names of the current green team. What about Tyson Gay versus Usain Bolt versus Asafa Powell versus Johan Blake? It's going to be one of those blue ribbon events. That was Tyson, I think. Usain Bolt enjoying his moments with the crowd again.
Yes, of course, United States of America highly fancied to defend their gold medals in beach volleyball, both of the men's and women's team, and of course, women's football team.
Interesting that they're backing. There's no government money. It all comes from sponsors and donations.
team and how well they're going to play it. 532, strong team. Wonderful atmosphere, wonderful.
Getting very good applause from thousands across the Atlantic. Followed by Uruguay. We're getting down towards the end, you will gather. Rodolfo Galazzo, who is a rower. It's their flag. First country to provide every school pupil with a free laptop. They could go and thank the man himself, couldn't they? Really?
They could indeed. They've won a total of 10 medals, 2 gold, both in football.
Uzbekistan!
Uzbekistan!
Another boxer carrying the flag here, Elshad Rasulov. Fifth Summer Games.
Gold medals in wrestling, one in boxing. They've won a total of 18 medals in the Summer Olympic Games. The team this time, 54 strong.
Vanuatu!
Vanuatu. Anolin Lulu from table tennis. He's their flag bearer.
Athletes are competing in the 100, the 800,
Venezuela!
Tennis.
And, another table tennis player. That's the flag of Venezuela, Fabiola Ramos. Fifth games. And another country to start in London in 1948.
Yes, it did, and they've won 11 medals over the years, just one gold. Most of the medals are in boxing.
Vietnam!
Vietnam!
Fencer this time. Nguyen Thinh Nhat. 14th appearance for Vietnam. 2 silver medals. Women's taekwondo in Sydney and men's weightlifting in Beijing.
Team of 18. This year.
They began in 1968 in Mexico City, their involvement with the Olympic movement. Their only medal won by Peter Holmberg in sailing in Seoul in 1988. Got a team of 7 here. 4 athletes, 2 sailors, 1 swimmer.
Yemen!
Yemen!
Southern part of the Arabian Peninsula. Saudi Arabia to the north, Oman to the west. Zambia, Prince Mumba in the 800 metres. He competed in Athens and now comes back to compete again. He wasn't in Beijing.
Last medal by Samuel Mateti in the 400 metre hurdles. Atlanta, the first in 1984. Boxing.
Zimbabwe!
The atmosphere building up in the Olympic Stadium. Zimbabwe, Kirsty Coventry, a double Olympic champion swimmer. That's the flag of Zimbabwe, and how nice it is to see Zimbabwe here. But the roar is for what comes next. And you'll forgive us for a little home pride.
Great Britain!
The flag in the hand of Chris Hoy. 3 gold medals in Beijing, and more to come here, he hopes, though not in as many competitions as he would have wished. And down from the ceiling come, I think it's 7 billion little pieces of paper. The thought was to remember those above as well as those that are down here competing. That's what crowd going wild.
I can't cannot begin to imagine what it must be like for these athletes to walk out here in front of their home crowd. I know how special it was when I marched in the opening ceremony in my Olympic Games, but I have to say, to do it on home soil must be just quite incredible.
47 medals were won in Beijing, ranked Great Britain fourth on the medal table. 19 gold, 13 silver, 15 bronze. A huge team. In the history of the Olympic Games, 33 Olympic champions in athletics alone, which is my sport, but there are so many more. Duke of Cambridge is there, the Duchess as well. So many special people in this Olympic stadium this evening. And so many with opportunities achieving their dreams. Plenty of cameras ready. The uniform, not that dissimilar, apart from the gold pieces, the uniform worn by every carrier of the torch. Prime Minister applauding there to the left, Lady Cameron. Prince Harry there as well. Did you doubt it?
No.
And a lot of people have put a lot of work getting these games on time. It's Charles and the Duchess of Cornwall. And I must say, I think it's nice to see the royal family out in force. Apart from the weather, it's been rather a special year this year. Many of the athletes will be there because they're away preparing in warmer climes. Which is a shame in a way, but you can understand it. But I don't know how you get around that problem.
No, it's very difficult, and certainly from an athlete's point of view, you train for a lifetime for this one fleeting opportunity. You don't want to do anything to jeopardise your chance of performing to your very best in the sporting arena. And for those athletes that have to compete tomorrow or even the following day, perhaps the excitement of this opening ceremony. And it is such a buzz, it is such an occasion. And these athletes that are here will remember it forever and a day.
Saw Clive Woodward going through there, the man who did so much for rugby and on with the British Olympic Association. I don't know whether any of the hockey players are in there because they get a day off. Although they've been, like most of the teams, playing all week in friendly matches.
At last, the flag in two hands, just for a brief rest. At this point, enjoying this moment. ...556 British competitors at home in front of their own crowd.
Bernie Cotton from the world of hockey. He's the assistant manager when the gold medal was won in 1988 in Seoul. Final part he played. Good work
Bank Arena since.
It's a colourful
picture on the field of play.
Ladies and gentlemen, the athletes of the 30th Olympiad,
covered by the athletes of the world. Entertained by the Arctic Monkeys. Fireworks. White Stadium. Coloured lights in the crowd. It makes for a wonderful scene here. Cyclists, very popular sport in this country at the moment. Tell you is you got to be free, come together.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez accueillir le président du comité d'organisation des Jeux Olympiques et Paralympiques de Londres 2012, Sébastien Coe, et le président du comité international olympique, Jacques Rogge.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the chairman of the London 2012 Olympic and Paralympic Games, Sébastien Coe, and the president of the International Olympic Committee, Jacques Rogge.
Your Majesty, Your Majesties, Your Royal Highnesses, President Rogge, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. To everyone in this stadium attending our opening ceremony, to every athlete waiting, ready, prepared to take part in these games, to everyone in every city and village in the world watching as we begin, welcome to London. Welcome. Welcome to the 2012 Olympic Games. Welcome from every one of us. I have never been so proud to be British and to be a part of the Olympic movement. As I am on this day, at this moment. The Olympics brings together the people of the world in harmony and friendship and peace to celebrate what is best about mankind. All my life, I have loved sport. You have to love sport to compete at it. There is a truth to sport, a purity, a drama, an intensity, a spirit that makes it irresistible to take part in and irresistible to watch. London 2012 seeks to capture all of this. London 2012 will inspire a generation. In every Olympic sport, there is all that matters in life. Humans stretched to the limit of their abilities, inspired by what they can achieve, driven by their talent to work harder than they can believe possible, living for the moment, but making an indelible mark upon history. To the athletes gathered here on the eve of this great endeavor, I say, that to you is given something precious and irreplaceable. To run faster, to jump higher, to be stronger. To my fellow countrymen, I say thank you. Thank you for making all this possible. In the next 2 weeks, we will show all that has made London one of the greatest cities in the world. The only city to have welcomed the Games 3 times. Each time we have done it, the world faced turbulence and trouble, and each time the Games have been a triumph. Our history as a thriving commercial centre, as a place where the people of all nations have for centuries come to meet, as a city which never stands still, this history has prepared us for today. For us too, for every Briton, just as the competitors, this is our time. And one day, we will tell our children and our grandchildren that when our time came, we did it right. Let us determine, all of us, all over the world, that London 2012 will see the very best of us. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce the President of the International Olympic Committee, Dr. Jacques Rogge.
Your Majesty, Your Majesties, Your Royal Highnesses, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, in just a few moments, the Olympic Games will officially return to London for the third time, setting an unmatched record for hosting the Games that spans more than a century. Thank you. Thank you, London, for welcoming the world to this diverse, vibrant, cosmopolitan city yet again. It has taken a lot of hard work by many people to get us to this point. I want to thank the entire team at the London Organising Committee, superbly led by Lord Coe, for their excellent and hard work. I also want to thank all the public authorities who have helped ensure that these Games will leave a lasting positive legacy long after the closing ceremony. And of course, we are all grateful to the thousands of dedicated volunteers who are being so generous generous with their time, their energy, and their welcoming smiles. For the first time in Olympic history, all the participating teams will have had female athletes, and this is a major boost for gender equality. In a sense, the Olympic Games are coming home tonight. This great sports-loving country is widely recognized as the birthplace of modern sport. It was here that the concepts of sportsmanship and fair play were first codified into clear rules and regulations. It was here that sport was included as an educational tool in the school curriculum. The British approach to sport had a profound influence on Pierre de Coubertin, our founder, as he developed the framework for the modern Olympic movement at the close of the 19th century. The values that inspired de Coubertin will come to life over the next 17 days as the world's best athletes compete in a spirit of friendship, respect and fair play. I congratulate all of the athletes who have earned a place at these Games. And to the athletes, I offer this thought. Your talent, your dedication and commitment brought you here. Now you have a chance to become true Olympians. That honor is determined not by whether you win, but by how you compete. Character counts far more than medals. Reject doping, Respect your opponents. Remember that you are all role models. If you do that, you will inspire a generation. Ces Jeux sont porteurs de beaucoup d'espoir. Espoir d'entente et de paix entre les 204 comités nationaux olympiques. Espoir de voir les jeunes générations s'inspirer des valeurs du sport. Espoir que ces Jeux puissent contribuer au développement durable. Chers athlètes, faites-nous rêver. Dear athletes, make us dream. I now have the honor to ask Her Majesty the Queen to open the games of the 30th Olympiad. Thank you.
I declare open the Games of London, celebrating the 30th Olympiad of the modern era.
Mesdames et messieurs, le drapeau olympique.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic flag.
The flag is carried by Doreen Lawrence. We salute her tireless thirst for justice.
UN Goodwill Ambassador Haile Gebrselassie. We applaud his fight against poverty.
Becker, Goodwill Ambassador for Children of Peace. We salute her courage.
Secretary General of the United Nations, Ban Ki-moon.
Winner of the Nobel Prize, Lema Bowie, a great peacemaker.
Shami Chakrabarti, the founder of Liberty. We salute her integrity.
Daniel Barenboim, who brings harmony in place of discord.
Marina Silva, United Nations Champion of the Earth.
Continents. wonderful that these people who've been successful in other fields can be here to carry the European flag.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous lever pour l'hymne olympique.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the Olympic anthem.
Composed by Spiros Samaras, Greek composer born in Corfu in 1863. Certainly the most popular choice is the man who would light the flame. In fact, it will be lit a little differently from usual. It is a closely guarded secret, no more than this time.
Mesdames et messieurs, Sarah Stevenson, médaille d'or olympique de taekwondo en 2008, va prêter le serment olympique au nom de tous les athlètes.
Ladies and gentlemen, to take the Olympic oath on behalf of all athletes, Sarah Stevenson, 2008 Olympic medalist, Taekwondo.
In the name of all the competitors, I promise that we shall take part in the Olympic Games. respecting and abiding by the rules which govern them, committing ourselves to a sport without doping and without drugs, in the true spirit of sportsmanship, for the glory of the sport and the honour of our teams.
Mesdames et messieurs, Mick Bassi, arbitre et juge de boxe, va prêter le serment olympique au nom de tous les juges.
Ladies and gentlemen, to take the Olympic oath on behalf of all judges, Mick Bassi, Olympic boxing referee and judge.
In the name of all the judges and officials, I promise that we shall officiate in these Olympic Games with complete impartiality, respecting and abiding by the rules which govern them, in the true spirit of sportsmanship.
Mesdames et messieurs, Eric Farrell, entraîneur de canoë-kayak, course en ligne, va prêter le serment olympique au nom de tous les entraîneurs.
Ladies and gentlemen, to take the Olympic oath on behalf of all coaches, Eric Farrell, MBE, Olympic canoe sprint coach.
In the name of all the coaches and other members of the athletes' entourage, I promise that we shall commit ourselves to ensuring that the spirit of sportsmanship and fair play is fully adhered to and upheld in accordance with the fundamental principles of Olympism.
Mesdames et messieurs, après avoir parcouru près de 20 600 km, la torche olympique est sur le point d'entrer dans le stade, encadrée par une garde d'honneur composée de 500 des hommes et femmes qui ont construit le parc olympique.
Ladies and gentlemen, after traveling 12,800 miles, the Olympic torch is about to enter the stadium. Witnessed by an honor guard of 500 of the men and women who built the Olympic Park.
Mesdames et messieurs, la flamme olympique.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic flame.
People who have contributed should be represented to form the Guard of Honour. Mr. Steve Redgrave makes his way into the centre of the stadium.
Le jeune rameur Cameron McRitchie.
Nominated by Steve Redgrave, young rower Cameron McRitchie.
La jeune coureuse Adele Tracy est nommée par Dame Kelly Holmes, MBE.
Young runner Adele Tracy is nominated by Dame Kelly Holmes, MBE.
jeune ambassadeur de Londres 2012, Jordan Duckett, est nommé par Duncan Goodhue, MBE.
London 2012 Young Ambassador Jordan Duckett is nominated by Duncan Goodhue, MBE.
La jeune coureuse Katie Kirk est nommée par Dame Mary Peters.
Young runner Katie Kirk is nominated by Dame Mary Peters.
Le jeune lanceur de javelot Aidan Reynolds est nommé par Lynn Davies, CBE.
Young javelin rower Aidan Reynolds is nominated by Lynn Davis, CBE.
La jeune coureuse Desiree Henry est nommée par Daley Thompson.
Young runner Desiree Henry is nominated by Daley Thompson.
All those who did the nominating. Lord, the young choices.
Mesdames et messieurs, représentant les Olympiens britanniques, 260 des médaillés d'or, d'argent et de bronze britanniques des Jeux Olympiques d'été et d'hiver depuis 1948.
Ladies and gentlemen, representing Britain's Olympians, 260 of Britain's gold, silver and bronze medalists from Summer and Winter Olympic Games since 1948.
Famous faces. Achieved so much for themselves and their country. Christopher Dean included. I'm sure Jimmy Thornton was there as well. Exploits. Presented. I should tell you that when the competing delegations arrived in London, they each received a copper petal. We saw them being carried around during the parade. And those petals are inscribed with the name of their country and the words 30th Olympiad, London 2012. We now have a part to play as the bell, the Olympic bell, rings out. Petals are now alive and are the cauldron of the London 2012 Games. In a very different way, fire has brought life to the Games. Spectacular sight in the end.
mesdames et messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, Paul McCartney.
Just a man, give him voice.
Nous espérons que vous avez passé une soirée formidable et vous souhaitons un bon retour.
Sir Paul McCartney brings to an end
a memorable beginning.
We hope that you've enjoyed the show, and we tell you that the competition begins tomorrow. Goodbye.